The issue of women's work is under the microscope at the employment court in Christchurch. Six former Gloriavale members are claiming they lived like slaves at the West Coast commune, working under a regime where they had no control. The women say members should be treated as employees rather than volunteers. But as Ryan Boswell reports, Gloriavale's leaders argue the system is fair.
The women of Gloriavale arriving at the employment court in Christchurch, ready to fight back.
They're not brainwashed. They're not ignorant. They're not uneducated.
A lawyer for the West Coast commune outlining how women choose to serve their 600-strong population by cooking, cleaning and washing for no pay.
They will say that Gloriavale is their home. It's a wonderful place to live and bring up large families with the support, love and caring of their fellow Christian brethren.
Serenity Pilgrim disagrees, saying she was forced to work 90 hours a week.
I definitely call it brainwashing, because right from day one you grow up knowing you don't have the option to even think about what you want to do.
She's one of six women born and raised at Gloriavale who've since left, now fighting to prove they should have been treated as employees and not volunteers.
I was upset when the Labour inspectorate reported I was a volunteer doing family work. If I had a choice, there was definitely no way I would ever have done what I was made to do.
In May, the court ruled that three former members who worked on farms and in factories were employees from the age of six. Today, Gloriavale argued this case is different and that taking care of each other is not a commercial enterprise.
In the sharing economy, there's no money changing hands for the services that are provided. It's not a catering business.
But the women's lawyer says if they refused to work, there was corporal punishment, food was withheld, and they were threatened with eternal damnation.
Submitting to the shepherds is in Gloriavale speak the same as submitting to God, because they are God and they interpret for God everything on this earth.
This is just day one of a month-long hearing with 50 witnesses expected to be called. Gloriavale is once again front and centre. Ryan Boswell, One News.